This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
In New Hampshire, a unique destination.
There is only one Henniker.
With family fun,
we introduce skiers and riders to the industry.
And adult taste.
So you do get a lot of those smoked meat flavors, kind of like a sausage kind of thing.
In Providence, bumper cars on ice.
My grandmother was on them a few weeks ago, and she's 80.
And south of the border, cuisine.
We want to give everybody a smile.
And at the tip of the Cape, a splash of color.
The pink room is not your mama's rouge, and it's inspired by
Good and Plenty.
And time to take in the view.
The natural beauty of Provincetown is unparalleled in the wintertime.
A tank away, next on Chronicle.
Good evening, everyone. In the mood for a road trip? Well, you just sit back and we'll do the driving.
Our first destination tonight, Henniker, New Hampshire. It's a great place to encourage future skiers. Plus, there's no other town like it on the planet. Shuss, sip, stay, see, and savor.
So you know how there's a Cambridge, Massachusetts, and a Cambridge, England, a Concord, New Hampshire, and a Concord, Massachusetts, a Woodstock just about everywhere. Well, it turns out that on the entire planet, there is only one Henniker. And here we are.
Family-owned Pat's Peak Ski Area provides the winter outdoor fun. Founded, owned, and operated by the Patinode family for the past 55 years.
So the group of Patinode brothers bought the land from their dad and made the trails and a lodge, and through the years have added on and have just grown it to what it is now.
It's a full-service mountain just 90 minutes from Boston. Snow sports director John Pollack calls it a feeder mountain.
We introduce skiers and riders to the industry. That's our niche. Our direction is to be an introduction to a skier or a rider. We want them to develop and learn here, feel comfortable, and graduate to a different mountain.
Pat's Peak has a wide range of instruction, after-school programs, youth and adult race teams, night skiing, a pub in the lodge for après ski, and while it may not be the biggest mountain,
we also have 28 trails for all abilities. We have 9 gladed areas, 3 terrain parks, a snow tubing park, so we really have something for everyone to come.
It's just kind of homey. You know, everybody says hello, first name basis. So I guess the size of it, the family ownership, blends right down to the staff that's here. Everybody's kind of buds.
The Contacook River winds its way through Henniker, passing by New England College and its 1,200 on-campus students. It also meanders near the 5-year-old Henniker Brewing Company, which is finding a niche in the landscape of 5,000 craft breweries with its distinctive flavor profiles.
We have a wide variety of different styles, colors, aromas that you're gonna get. Like Splitter, our smoked golden ale that we just came out with. There's not a lot of beers that are like that on the market right now.
So you do get a lot of those smoked meat flavors, kind of like a sausage kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really, I've never tasted any beer like that ever in my life. That's awesome.
Head brewer Devin Bush says he has a fairly simple test when developing his unique blends.
I've learned that if you don't want two of something, it's usually not that good. So whatever the beers I want to make, I want you want to go back for a second one.
Huh.
So that's kind of the way I look at beer a lot of time is if you're not drinking two, then don't make the beer.
Henniker Brewing does have popular staples like IPAs and hoppy pale ales. Their beers have wide distribution in New England, and their tap room and Saturday tours draw hundreds of visitors each week. As they celebrate their 5th anniversary, some reflection.
I was very naive coming into the business. I just thought, hey, if we come out with great beer, people will put it on tap, right? But it's a lot more work than that goes behind the scenes. So it's definitely a lot of work, but it's been paying off.
Jeff Breckbuehl and Bruce Barnes say something similar.
The reality kicks you in the patukas.
About running the Colby Hill Inn, which they purchased 2 years ago. But now they are hitting their stride. Bruce is a former New York City restaurateur who spent most of the last decade as chef at the World Bank in Washington, D.C.
I've always been interested in global cuisine, so I'm able to kind of take that and translate that into our menu here. So I think, you know, it's globally inspired cuisine using local ingredients.
The goal is to make the inn a dining destination with offerings like pan-seared salmon, local cheese plates, and mouth-watering buttermilk fried chicken and waffles. They are also busy with weddings and other functions booked for the barn and inn. Rooms and suites have been updated since they took ownership, and they are very happy to be in Henniker.
We like doing outdoor things, so it's great for that, the kayaking, the biking, hiking, etc. You know, it's a small town, so we weren't exactly sure what that would be like living in again, but there's a real cosmopolitan mix of people here. There's a real group of people here who really appreciate good food, good wine.
As for trading the hectic life of Washington, D.C. for life in a New England inn,
I tell everybody I'm not only a chef, I'm the butcher, baker, goat herder, toilet plumber. It's an all-hands-on thing, but you know, you are living your dream. We really strive hard to make a great dining experience and a great stay.
We're glad we're here. It's a beautiful area.
All right, that food at Kobe Hill looked delicious, and they've actually won awards for their food.
2016 Best New Restaurant in New Hampshire Magazine, so they have been awarded for that. And you, why Henniker, you ask? Why is it called Henniker?
Yes.
Well, it's named for Sir John Henniker, a London fur and a leather merchant who had shipping interests in Boston and in New Hampshire, and so they named it after him. He was also a member of the British Parliament.
All right, what a fascinating
Only
little
one
town.
Henniker.
Next, the art of ceviche.
It's like making a lemonade.
Plus, where Sarah left Edgar.
The story goes that they broke off their engagement here at the Athenaeum.